فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد، وإن شرح الكتاب نزهة النظر في توضيح نخبة الفكر. As we said before, we are doing the sharah of نزهة النظر, نخبة الفكر. We are relying on the sharah of Ibn Hajar رحمه الله رحمة واسعة. The matn is written by him, the نخبة الفكر. And also the sharah, نزهة النظر, is also written by him. So the sharah that we're relying on is also by the author himself as well. The Shaykh Rahimahullah Ibn Hajar, he says in his kitab Nukhbat al-Fikr, he says, وَخَبَرُ الْآحَادِ بِنَقْلِ عَدْلٍ تَامُ الضَّبْطِ بِنَقْلِ عَدْلٍ تَامِ الضَّبْطِ بِنَقْلِ عَدْلٍ تَامِ الضَّبْطِ مُتَّصِلِ السَّنَدِ غَيْرَ مُعَلَّلٍ وَلَا شَاذٍ وَالصَّحِيحُ لِذَاتِهِ. The author rahimahullah, Shaykh Hafiz ibn Hajar, here he goes into the definition of what is a hadith which is sahihul lidatihi. But before that he says, wa khabarul ahad. How many types did we categorize the khabar into, Imran? The khabarul ahad. Yeah? Khabarul ahad. We categorize the khabar al-ahad into three types. What were they, Sa'ad? Mashhur, Aziz, Gharib. So we categorize the khabar al-ahad into those three. When Hafiz ibn Hajar says, wa khabar al-ahad bi naqli adlin tamid dabti, tamid dabti, what does he mean in the khabar al-ahad here? Does he mean mashhur? Does he mean Aziz? Does he mean gharib? Which one does he mean? He means all of them, mashallah. So he means all three of them. The definition for them is the sahih lidati is this one. And this is the first categorization of what? اعتبارُ الآحاد. Categorizing the ahad من حيث القبول والرد, صح؟ In terms of acceptance and rejection. So he said it's حسن لذاته. Sorry, صحيح لذاته. And the author رحمه الله, here he placed five conditions. The first condition he mentions is اتصال الإسنادي. That the chain of narration, متصل السندي, that the chain of narration is connected. الشرط الثاني, the second condition that he mentions is عدالة رواته, that the narrators that are narrating are reliable. They have high integrity. عدالة رواته, his narrators have high integrity. ضبط رواته, ضبط رواته is that the precision of the narrators, which is number three. Number four, سلامته سندا ومتنا من الشذوذ, that the chain of narration is free from any opposition. In terms of its chaining and in terms of its wording. And the last but not least condition, الشرط الخامس, the fifth condition he mentions is سلامته سندا ومتنا من العلة, that its chain and its wording are safe from any hidden defects. And all of these five types of conditions. So if a hadith, remember we said this before, we said the hadith which is mutawatir, it's not divided into maqbool and mardood, sah? If a hadith is mutawatir, it's reached multitude narration, it's accepted straight away. True or false? Yeah? It's accepted. There's no need to research it. But if the khabar is ahad, ahad here means mashur, aziz, or gharib, any of those three, what did we say? It's observed, it's looked into. It can be maqbool, and it can also be mardood. It can be either accepted or it can be rejected. And the khabar which is ahad is categorized into these four. The first one, it's been sahihul li dhatihi. And what's sahihul li dhatihi? Five conditions. It has to have five conditions. The first of those five conditions is ittisalus sanadi. Ittisalul isnadi. That the chain of narration is connected. The chain of narration is connected. Each one we need to study properly. Each of those five conditions. The first of those five conditions is أن يكون السند متصلا. What does it mean that the chain of narration has to be connected? What it means is that أن كل راو من رواة الإسناد قد تحمل. That every narrator in the chain of narration has taken from the person in which he's narrating from. He's taken it from them. For instance, we have Ali and we have Muhammad. So we have a hadith with us where Ali narrates from Muhammad. If I want to now, Ali narrates from Muhammad. If I want to narrate from Ali, what would I have to have? If I want to narrate this hadith, I would have to be in contact with Ali. I would have to have taken this narration directly from Ali. And then Ali has to directly have taken this narration from who? Muhammad. So I have to have taken it from Ali. And Ali has to have taken it from who? Muhammad. And it has to be done in that way. This hadith, this is called what? Ittisal al-sanad. Scholars of hadith, they look at two things. When they want to look at the chain of narration being authentic, they first of all look at if these two people met. The second thing they look at is they look at siyagh al-tahammul. What form has he used to take this narration from him? In what way has he expressed himself when he was taking this narration from him? Are you with me? If he says حَدَّثَنَا أَوْ أَخْبَرَنَا, he says حَدَّثَنَا أَوْ أَخْبَرَنَا. حَدَّثَنَا means he told us. أَخْبَرَنَا means he's informed us. We're going to come to those terms, what the differences are. Are you with me? Any of those two terms, if he uses it, and he's of course a reliable person, so Ali says حَدَّثَنَا مُحَمَّدٌ. Muhammad told us. This now narration is called what? So I say حَدَّثَنَا عَلِيٌ قَالَ حَدَّثَنَا مُحَمَّدٌ. حَدَّثَنَا عَلِيٌ قَالَ حَدَّثَنَا مُحَمَّدٌ. جميل. This is good. This chain is what? It's connected. لأن I heard from Ali, Ali heard from Muhammad, and the form that's been used here to take the chain from one another is what? حَدَّثَنَا أَنْ أَخْبَرَنَا. The siyagh, that's good. The second form is when the person says an. An. It's the second form. If I say أَخْبَرَنَا عَلِيٌ, Ali told us, an Muhammad. The scholars of hadith, they will look at, since Ali now used the word an when he was taking this narration from who, he expressed himself by using the word an from Muhammad. Are you with me? The scholars of hadith will look at Ali now, and they will look at his situation. If Ali is a mudallis, if Ali is a what? If he's a mudallis, then they won't accept this an from him. If Ali is a mudallis, then they won't take from Ali the an that he has used to express himself in taking this narration from Muhammad. Why? Because this word an, it doesn't show that Ali heard from Muhammad directly. There could be somebody else in between. There could be somebody else in between. So what is needed from Ali? Since Ali is a mudallis, what is needed from him? He has to do tasrih al-sima. He has to bring the narration with a direct usage. So he has to say akhbarana or anba'ana. That's what they need from him. They'll say, why haven't you said akhbarana? Why haven't you said anba'ana? That's what they'll say to him. That's what they will say to Ali. But if Ali is not a mudallis, we'll take what mudallis means, but he's not a mudallis. If Ali is not a mudallis, if he uses the word an or qala, they'll take it from him. Will they take it from him? Because he's not a mudallis, they will take it from him. I will take what a mudallis is, inshaAllah ta'ala, soon. It's going to come to us soon, bi'idhnillahi al-kareem. So the first condition is أن يكون السند متصلا, that this chain of narration is what? Is connected. Again, the scholars, what do they look at? They look at the two individuals if they met one another. And they also look at how he took it from him. So if he took it from him, and he took this narration from him, بِالسَّمَاعِ, by listening to the teacher, by hearing what the teacher says, and he was in the gathering of the sheikh, and the sheikh was reading on him, then when he is trying to pass on that narration, if he wants to give that narration on, he would use the word حَدَّثَنَا. He was listening to the sheikh was reading on him, what does he do? He uses the term حَدَّثَنَا to pass it on. Or he would say سَمِعْتُ, I heard. But if he read on the sheikh, أو بالقراءة في العرض على شيخه, or if he goes and he reads on the sheikh, then this is also من طرق التحمل, it's from the forms of taking the narration. But he would have to use the word أخبارنا. Now you know the difference between حدثنا سمعت وأخبارنا. Are you with me, brothers and sisters? If the sheikh is the one who read the narration, and he was a student sitting in front of his sheikh, and the sheikh was reading on to him, and the sheikh was the one who was bringing the narrations, and he's sitting in the gathering, and he took the narration by listening, then when he goes later and he wants to tell other people about that narration, or if he wants to pass that narration over, he would use the word حَدَّثَنَا or سَمِعْتُ. He would use that. Good. But if he went and he read on the sheikh bil ardi, he read on the sheikh ala sheikhi, and the sheikh was listening, then when he goes out now and he goes out to pass on that narration, he would use what? Akhbarana. He would use what? He would use akhbarana fulanun. So told us. Are you with me? Again, if he's safe from tadlis, he's not a mudallis. وَلَهُ سِمَاعٌ بِالْجُمْلَةِ, and in generally, he heard this narration from the sheikh. Either be, when we say he took from the sheikh, طُرُقُ التَّحَمُّل means he took from the sheikh, either by sama', by listening to the sheikh, or بِالْقِرَاءَةِ فِي الْعَرْضِ عَلَى شَيْخِهِ, whichever of those two, and he's not a mudallis, then the scholars of hadith don't mind how he narrates. They don't care. He can say qala, he can say haddathana, he can say akhbarana, he can say an. They'll take it regardless. Okay? The siyagh al-tahammul, this form that he uses here, they will take it from him because he's not a mudallis. And in generally, he's known to take from the sheikh. Are you with me? So they will take that hadith and they will consider it وَيُحْكَمُ بِاتِّصَالِ السَّنَدِ مَعَ عَنْ عَلَتِهِ. They will consider this hadith to be connected even though his an'ana is there. As for if the narrator is a mudallis, we'll see what a mudallis inshallah is soon. بإذن الله الكريم. Then what the scholars do is التوقف في الرواية. They withhold from his narration. They can't accept his narration. Why? Because there could be somebody who threw out the chain of narration. Because he's a mudallis, that's what he does. That's his job as a mudallis. And that person who he probably could have dropped off, we need to know who they are. So we can give them a good ruling. Let me go back to the example that I gave you before. We came and we narrated from who? Ali. Ali narrated from who? Muhammad. Very good. How would Ali narrate from Muhammad? And Ali here, in this situation, Ali is a what? He heard this narration from his Sheikh Muhammad. He took it from him. How did he take it from him? What طرق التحمل has he taken it from him by? He took it from him, sama'. So he transmits, he heard it from his Sheikh in a gathering. Jameen. Took the narration. He now goes and wants to pass that narration over. And he's not a mudallis. If he says, if we say that حدثني علي, Ali told me, عن محمد, from Muhammad, is the narration of Ali taken? Yeah. Because Ali has two things in place. First thing is that he has what? Muhammad is his sheikh. He turned this narration from him. He was in the gathering of his sheikh. Second thing is that Ali is not known to be a mudallis. He's not a mudallis. This hadith is muttasil al-sanad. Very good. But what about if we say, are you with me, brothers? We say, who did we hear this narration from? Who did we hear it from? We heard it from Ali, right? And then Ali heard it from who? Muhammad. If we go and we say, an Ali, an Muhammad, from Muhammad, and we don't mention Ali, we say, an Muhammad, what are we? We are mudallis. We did tadlis, right? We haven't lied by saying, Ali, Muhammad told me. Muhammad, we didn't say, we just said, from Muhammad. Who have we dropped out? But in this situation, you know the person who got dropped out is Ali. Are you with me? But in some circumstances, the person who's been dropped, we don't know. If we find out that the person who he dropped was Ali, and we find out, are you with me? We'll accept it based on the other narrations where we found out. As for this narration, we're not going to accept it. Because it could be Ali and it could be somebody else. And the fact that that narrator, we don't know of his hal. We don't know who he is as an individual. We don't know عينuhu ولا حاله. We don't know who he is as an individual. We don't know his situation. What do we do here? We don't accept it. Because it is a disconnected chain of narration. We and Muhammad didn't meet. Somebody is between us. This chain is now disconnected. So this is the first condition that was meant to be in place, right? For the hadith to be sahih, right? It's what? اتصال السند, that the chain of narration is connected. Very good. The second condition that the Shaykh rahimahullah he mentioned in Hajar is that أن يكون رواة عدولا, that the narrators who are narrating their hadith, they have to be عدول. Here the question is, فما هو تعريف العدل? What's the definition of عدل? What's the definition of عدل? If you look at the kitab written by Ibn Hajar, the نزهة النظر, he says, والمراد بالعدل من له ملكة تحمله على ملازمة التقوى والمروءة Here he says, من له ملكة. A person who has innate strength ability. تحمله, that ability, that strength, takes him towards التقوى, and it takes him to what? والمروءة. And what does it also take him to? It takes him to مروءة. مروءة here means morality. Anything that has morality. Something مروءة. Are you with me? That's the definition that the Sheikh Rahimahullah. Now here's this term that Sheikh Ibn Hajar Rahimahullah Ta'ala uses, the word malaka. وَقَدْ يُشْتَشْكَلُ It could be ishkal, it could bring a doubt to you. The term that he uses, which is the word malaka. What does it mean, malaka? It means أَنْ يَكُونَ الرَّاوِيُ تَقِيًّا مُجْتَنِبًا That the person is taqi and is mujtanibah, meaning he's far from what? لِلْصَغَائِرِ The minor sins بِطِبَاعَتِهِ In his nature. By nature, should be this. Now, that definition, that doesn't mean that the individual never does sins. And al-adl, if you say that the person has high integrity, this would entail that you're basically conditioning that people are infallible in order for narrations to be taken from them. ولذلك الإمام الشافعي رحمه الله, he said, as it's in the Kitab al-Kifaya, page 138, he says, الإمام الشافعي, لا أعلم أحدا أعطى طاعة الله حتى لم يخلطها بمعصية إلا يحيى بن زكريا عليه السلام. The Imam al-Shafi'i said, I don't know anyone who has been given obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala which he never mixed it with any sins except Yahya ibn Zakariya عليه السلام. He's the only person I know, he said. ولا عصى الله فلم يخلط بطاعة. And who disobeyed Allah and didn't mix it with obedience. فإذا كان الأغلب الطاعة. Pay attention here. This is the qa'ida now that Ibn Muhammad ibn Idris al-Shafi'i mentions. He says, فإذا كان الأغلب الطاعة. If the person's overwhelming positions are obedience, فهو المعدل. He is the person who is معدل, who has عدل. وإذا كان الأغلب المعصية, if the overwhelming majority of the time this person is coming with sins, فهو المجرح. Then this person is what? He's critiqued and criticized. Are we all together? So what is it? We look at the person's overwhelming positions. فإذا كان الأغلب الطاعة, the overwhelming majority of times is obedient, فهو المعدل. وإذا كان الأغلب المعصية, فهو المجرح. If the overwhelming majority of times this person is just sinning, is shortcomings, then what do? You say, he's a what? He's criticized. Al-Imam ibn Hibban, rahimahullah, in his muqaddimah, first of all, it is Muqaddimah of his Sahih. He mentions the first of all in page 151. He says, العدالة في الإنسان. عدالة in a person is هو أن يكون أكثر أحواله طاعة الله. That the overwhelming majority of his positions and his stances are obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لأن متى لم نجعل العدل إلا من لم يوجد منه معصية بحال أدانا ذلك إلى أن ليس في الدنيا عدل. Because he said, if we make the عدالة for a person who has no mistakes, so we say no sins. If we say عدالة means that somebody who doesn't have no sin whatsoever, then that would lead us to إلى أن ليس في الدنيا عدل. It will take us to believing that there is no person on the face of this earth who is adil. إِذِ النَّاسُ لَا تَخْلُوا أَحْوَالُهُمْ مِنْ وُرُودِ خَلَلِ الشَّيْطَانِ فِيهَا Because a person, his situations never is absent from what? مِنْ وُرُودِ خَلَلِ الشَّيْطَانِ The deficiency shaitan will place in you, that weakness he'll put in you. So he says, بَلِ الْعَدْلُ مَنْ كَانَ ظَاهِرُ أَحْوَالِهِ طَاعَةَ اللَّهِ وَالَّذِي يُخَالِفُ الْعَدْلَ مَنْ كَانَ أَكْثَرُ أَحْوَالِهِ مَعْصِيَةُ اللَّهِ So he repeats the point that we mentioned. مَنْ كَانَ ظَاهِرُ أَحْوَالِهِ طَاعَةَ اللَّهِ Anyone whose outer appearance is obedience of Allah. وَالَّذِي يُخَالِفُ الْعَدْلَ And the one who opposes عَدْل and is not in line with عَدْل or he's not a person who has عَدْل is مَنْ كَانَ أَكْثَرُ أَحَوَالِهِ مَعْصِيَةُ اللَّهِ The person who is the majority of his stances and his positions are what? Disobedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now the scholars, they mention five things. Five things have to be in place for the person to have عَدْل. A person is not عَدْل, he doesn't have عَدْل إِلَّا إِذَا تَحَقَّقَتْ فِيهِ أَوْصَافُ Unless there's these descriptions that are present in him. The first one is Al-Islam. The first one is Al-Islam. That the person, he is a يُشْتَرَطُ الْإِسْلَامُ فِي الرَّاوِي Islam is a condition for the narrator. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he refused for a disbeliever to be adl. A disbeliever, he is غير مؤتمن. He's not entrusted in... How can he be trusted with a hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he be entrusted with it? When he has disbelieved in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When he has what? He's disbelieved in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the backbone for narration is what? Truthfulness. So the disbeliever doesn't have a sidq. Number two. The second condition is أن يكون مكلفا. أن يكون مكلفا means that the person is بالغ عاقل. بالغ means that he reaches age of puberty. And عاقل means what? عاقل means that he has sanity. بالغ means he's reached age of puberty. And عاقل means that he has sanity. The reason is because these two individuals, which is the بالغ and the عاقل, the thing that they have in common is that they are, if the person is not بالغ and the person is not عاقل, and he's not reached age of puberty, or the person has no sanity, he loses what is needed in narration, which is يستوعب الرواية. He will not be able to do تمييز, to distinguish one from another. He will not be able to distinguish. Distinguish factor is needed. Well, you may use بين الأشياء. He will not also be able to comprehend fully the narration. He won't be able to. But then the scholars, they said, what's the ضابط of تمييز then? If you say that the بالغ and the عاقل, when would we know that this child, he is mashallah? They said, if he أن يميز بين الحمار والبقرة. If he can tell the difference between a donkey and a cow, then this is mumayyiz. Tamiz is there. Are you with me? Very good. So the majnoon and the child narration is not taken from them. A child who doesn't know the reality of things, he doesn't know it. He doesn't know the distinguishing factors between information. And you all know that a newborn child, or not even a new, but little kids, you can tell them about, you can tell them about a, you know, animals, birds, horses that fly, and you can tell them about fairy tales, and they will listen, they'll believe in that, sahih? They will believe in that, because they can't really tell the reality of things, okay? The reality of things. And you know, this land that we live in, the non-Muslims, what do? They tell the child about the tooth fairy. The child takes his tooth out and he puts it under his pillow, and then all that happens is that his mum puts £2 or £1 under his pillow, and his parents do it, and then they tell the child that the tooth fairy came, and that the tooth fairy put this pound under your pillow. Sah. So, but the child believes in that. They believe in Santa Claus, you know, the kuffar. So this shows you children will take anything that they're being told and anything that they are informed about. Because of the fact that they don't know the reality of things. لا يعرفون حقيقة الأشياء. They don't know the reality of things. ولا يميز بين الأخبار. They can't distinguish between the situations. Are you with me? They can't. They can't tell what is truth and what's a lie. They can't. So even sometimes when they talk, the children, they will tell you things which are delusional. So because of that, it's not It's not accepted from them. And their narrations are not taken on board. But what I want you to all remember, this is important. All of this what I mentioned right now, which is Al-Baligh and Al-Aqil, and also Islam, that I mentioned, all of those, brothers and sisters, pay attention. All of those which I just mentioned, which is, I only mentioned two, right? And also the other ones which will come to inshallah ta'ala soon, but for the first two that I just mentioned, which is what? Al-Islam and Mukallaf, right? Those two, the condition of them is only عند الأداء. Are you with me, brothers? It's only a condition, and it is only conditioned حال الرواية, when the person is giving the narration, that he's a Muslim and that he's reached age of puberty and he is mukallaf. حال الرواية. And it is not لا حال السماع والتحمل. It is not conditioned when he heard the narration and when he took on the narration. He doesn't have to be a Muslim. He can hear the narration when he's a disbeliever, and he can narrate it to us later when he becomes a Muslim, and it will be accepted from him. Are you with me? And you know the famous hadith of Al-Imam al-Bukhari brings in his Sahih, hadith of Jubair ibn Mut'im. Sah? Where did Jubair? Yeah? Surah al-Tur. What did he say? Kada qalbi an yatir. Was he a Muslim or was he a disbeliever? So Jubair radiallahu ta'ala anhu was not a Muslim. So ulama, innama tushtaratul adala, they said that the adala is conditioned hala riwaya, when the narration is being conveyed. La hala sima'i wa tahammuli fata'ammal. Ponder on that point. Think about it and don't get it confused, and think that to yourself. The same is with the child. If the child sees something when he's young and he grows up and he remembers it, it's taken from him. Number three, the third condition for what? The adala is أَلَّا يَكُونَ مِمَّنْ ثَبَتَ فِسْقُهُ. أَلَّا يَكُونَ مِمَّنْ ثَبَتَ فِسْقُهُ. It should be a person or an individual whose fisq is not established. What does it mean, ثَبَتَتْ فِسْقُهُ? It's a person, يَأْتِي بِالْكَبَائِرِ وَيَجْهَرُ. He does major sins in the open. And the ma'asi, he's openly an open sinner. He's an open sinner. Like the woman who doesn't wear hijab, or the man who cuts his beard. This is a what? كَبِيرَةٌ مِنَ الْكَبَائِرِ. It's major sins. These are major sins. Are their narration accepted? No, none are void. Why? Because they are doing what? يَأْتِي بِالْكَبَائِرِ. They are coming with major sins. وَيَجْهَرُ بِالْمَعَاصِي. And they are doing the sins openly. ولذلك الإمام الخطيب البغدادي mentions in his kitab الجامع لأخلاق الراوي وأداب السامع, he says وَيَثْبُتُ الْفِسْقُ بِأُمُورٍ كَثِيرَةٍ لَا تَخْتَصُ بِالْحَدِيثِ. He said fisq, it can be established in many things and it's not specific to hadith. وَمَا مَا يَخْتَصُ بِالْحَدِيثِ. But what is specific to hadith is أن يضع متون الأحاديث, that he lies and he fabricates the wording of the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, أو أسانيد المتون, or he fabricates the chain of the hadith. ومنها, and from it is also أن يدعي السماع ممن لم يلقه. And also from the fisq that are specific to hadith is he claims that he heard from a narrator when he didn't really hear from him. He has never heard from him this hadith, and he says, I heard this hadith from this individual. Here's a question that's very important, which the ulama speak about, which is, هَلْ يُشْتَرَطُ فِي الْعَدْلِ. Is it a condition in the adl, أَلَّا يَقَعَ فِي كَبِيرَةٍ أَبَدًا, that he never does a major sin? Never. In other words, if a narrator comes with كبيرة من الكبائر, He comes with a major sin. ثُمَّ تَابَ مِنْهَا And he comes back from it and he repents. Is his adala rejected? Sorry, is that, sorry, repentance going to reject every, is that repentance going to be accepted? Or will he still be criticized for that major sin that he came with? So if he repents from a major sin that he done, do we bring him back his adala and say you're an adil person now? Or is he always going to be criticized for this major sin that he came with? And would it be stuck with him? I'lam, brothers and sisters, I want you to know, علمني الله وإياكم, may Allah teach me and you all, that it's not from the condition of adl that a person doesn't fall into sins. And we did mention that. Rather, a person can fall into sins. And quick does a believer repent, of course. And he comes back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and he runs back to his Lord. Because we know that there's no one on the face of this earth which is, we know there's no one on the face of this earth who is ma'asum min al-khatay. We know that there's no one on the face of this earth who's infallible from mistakes and errors. So the ulama, they say that if he does the kabiratu min al-kabair, he does any other sin, they accept it if he repents. Tawbah nasuha. Amma al-kadhib. As for lying, which is a kabira, but they give it a different taqseem. Are you with me? Because this is from the what? Huwa min ashaddi asbab al-fisq. This is from the greatest form of fisq. Are you with me? So would the repentance be accepted? Fihi tafsilun inda al-ulama. The ulama have tafsil in this matter. The tafsil that they have is number one. فَإِنْ كَانَتِ الْكَبِيرَةُ If the kabira, the major sin here is كَذِبًا عَلَىٰ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ He lies about the Prophet. فَالرَّاوِي سَاقِطُ الْعَدَالَةِ أَبَدًا Until the day of judgment, his narration is rejected. Even if he repents. وَلَوْ تَابَ فَتَوْبَتُ بَيْنَهُ وَبَيْنَ رَبِّهِ They won't say that his repentance won't be accepted, meaning that's between him and Allah. That's between him and Allah. As for his narrations, فَهِيَ مَرْدُودَةٌ أَبَدًا It's always going to be rejected. مَا حَدَّثَ بِهِ قَبْلَ تَوْبَةِ أَوْ بَعْدَهَا His narrations that he narrated before and the ones he's going to narrate are all going to be rejected. The ones that he did before, the narrations that he came with before the lie, and the narrations that he has come with what? After the lie, after he repented from it. All of them are going to be rejected. That's if he lied upon the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The second one is, وَإِنْ كَانَ الْكَذِبُ فِي كَلَامِ النَّاسِ If it's issues, day-to-day life, he lies about people's statements, he lies about situations about himself, مِمَّا لَا دَخَلَ لَهُ فِي الدِّينِ Which has no Islamic ruling to it. In other words, he's not lying about the deen. فَلَا يُحِلُّ حَرَامًا He's not making haram what is halal. And he's not making halal that which is haram. And then he repents, قُبِلَتْ تَوْبَتُهُ His repentance, inshallah, will be accepted. وَرُدَّتْ إِلَيْهِ عَدَالَتُهُ And his integrity and his adala will be brought back to him. وَمِنْ ثَمَّ And after that, قَبِلْنَا رِوَايَتُهُ We will accept his narrations. We will accept his narrations. But what you need to... This tafsir that I mentioned, are you with me, brothers and sisters? This tafsir that I mentioned is generally mentioned in Kutub al-Mustalah. Like when you go to the tatbiqat al-ulama, when you look at the scholars, what they practically do, and what manifests and is seen in their works, is that أَنَّ الْعُلَمَاءِ وَأِمَّةُ الْحَدِيثِ لَا يَكْتَرِثُونَ That they are not excessive in what? In taking the narrations of those people. Even if he repented from day-to-day matters that he used to lie about, they avoid his narrations. The majority of those people that they stick with is التي رواها وصدق فيها the narrations that have been told regarding it Because what they believe is even the one who repented, if he tells a narration which is what? Are you with me, brothers and sisters? If he mentions a narration, yeah, if he mentions a narration that he's telling the truth and he's truthful about it, the ulama believe, and he says, and the Prophet did say that, inshallah Allah will protect it on somebody else's tongue who's truthful, who never lied before. Are you with me? So through that, inshallah ta'ala, that will come clear. The fourth condition for adala is يُشْتَرَطُ فِي الرَّاوِي أَنْ يَتَّقِيَ خَوَارِمَ الْمُرُوءَةِ, that he abstains from things that could damage his morality. خَوَارِمُ الْمُرُوءَةِ, خَوَارِمُ الْمُرُوءَةِ, the definition is الْأُمُورُ الَّتِي تُسْتَهْجَنُ فِي عُرْفِ النَّاسِ وَتَدُلُّ بِمَجْمُوعِهَا عَلَى أَنَّ الرَّاوِي لَيْسَ أَهْلًا لِلتَّحَمُّلِ الْحَدِيثِ. It's not things that are halal or haram. It's not. It's issues that are what? Issues that go against the custom of the people. It's, for instance, a person wearing a vest. If a person comes right now and in front of you, they wear a vest. And they wear a quarter length, which is above their ankles. Their knees, so it covers their awrah, but they got a vest. This is going to be called khawarim al-muru'ah. His arm is seen, his armpits are seen. It's khawarim al-muru'ah. A narration won't be taken from him. But what has he done? Is it haram? Is it haram? But is khawarim al-muru'ah. If I came today with a vest, and I came with a quarter length, and I sat in front of you all and I said, inna alhamdulillah, none of you could bring me dalil to say what I'm doing is haram. Sah? And that it's right or wrong. But when you're going to say this is khawarim al-muru'ah. Sahih? ولذلك, sometimes you see some people who are making videos and they're meant to be du'at. But what they're wearing is khawarim al-muru'ah. It goes against the urf al-nas that the people look up to. From a da'i, true or false. Yeah, he goes to the gym, he records himself on the gym machine and he puts it on YouTube, a public platform where the people can all watch him. Sahih? Or he takes off his t-shirt. He covers his aura from his knees to his navels. But what is he showing? His chest, showing his arms. It goes against khawarim al-muru'ah. There's no need for them to show us this. Are you with me? But the khawarim al-muru'ah changes from time to time, places to places. Are you with me? Does it not? It does. There is something that is seen as khawarim al-muru'ah inda salaf, according to the pious predecessors, but to us is no longer from the khawarim al-muru'ah. Such as al-aklu fi al-turuqat, eating on the road. If you see somebody eating on the road right now, is it khawarim al-muru'ah? Not where are we? No, not a sister. We're not talking about a sister. Sisters, no. I'm talking about if a brother was out on the road, he was eating. It goes against khawarim al-muru'ah. Sahih? It goes against khawarim al-muru'ah. Or does it not? Depends how you look at it. Some things do change. They can change from time to time, places to places, culture to culture. There's a funny story that an imam, Khatib al-Baghdadi, mentions in his kitab Jami' al-Akhlaq al-Rawi wa Adab al-Sami'. This is a little funny story. Khatib al-Baghdadi, he says, عن علان الوراق قال, علان الوراق, he said, رأيت العتابي يأكل خبزا على طريق بباب الشام فقلت له ويحك أما تستحي. He said, I saw العتابي eating khubz in the road. So I said to him in a bibab al-sham, فقلت له, I said to him, ويحك, destruction be with you, أما تستحي, are you not shy? فقال لي, he then said to me, أرأيت لو كنا في دار فيها بقرة. He said, what about If I ate in a building or in a place where there are cows, أكنت تحتشم أن تأكل وهي تراك? Would you eat whilst the cows are looking at you? He said, yeah, I would eat, no problem. Why not? He then said to him, فاصبر then, be patient. He said, you would eat in front of a cow. You wouldn't be shy of eating in front of a cow. He said, no, I would not be shy, I would eat. He said, okay, فاصبر, be patient. حتى أعلمك, so I can teach you that these people, all of them are cows. So what did he do? ثم قام فوعى. He stood up and he gave a reminder. وقص ودعى. And he preached to the people. حتى كثر الزحاب. Until the place became overcrowded. علي ثم قال لهم. Then he said to them. روي لنا. It has been narrated to us. من غير وجه. From more than a one narration. This man, he wants to show the other guy these are all cows. So he said to him, it has been narrated to us. After he gave him a long reminder and a long heart-softening speech, then he said to them, it has been narrated in more than one way. مَنْ بَلَغَ لِسَانُهُ If anybody of amongst you, the tip of his tongue reaches the tip of his nose, لَمْ يَدْخُلِ النَّارَ He will never enter the hellfire. More than one narration has come to us like that. قَالَ فَمَا بَقِيَ مِنْهُمْ أَحَدٌ There was not a person in the gathering إِلَّا أَخْرَجَ لِسَانَهُ يَوْمِ He brought out his tongue, trying to make his tongue touch his nose. So he can reach it. Then he said to him, أَلَا أُخْبِرُكَ Did I not tell you أَنَّهُمْ بَقَرُ These people are cows. So eating in front of them is no problem. على كل حال خوارم المروءة changes time to time, places to places. It can change. What can be seen as خوارم المروءة here may not be seen yet. And that's why sometimes it's very important, especially when you travel to countries, you always try to learn the people's culture, what they do and what they don't do. And a lot of the times when we travel to countries, what do? We always look at where we came from. And that's the standard that everything should be. And it's not the case. I travel, for example, to Somalia. I want Somalia to be exactly like England. That's wrong. These people have their own culture. They've got their own way of life. They've got their own way of dressing. They've got their own way of doing things. Somebody else goes to Pakistan or India. And they land and they come to the country. And when they land, what do they see? Huh? When they land and they come to the country, they see a whole different look to life through them. And automatically, the way he thinks is right and every the way they look. Does that make sense? That's not right. People have their adat, people have their norms, people have their cultures. When you come, your job is to see what is the norm. As norms are followed, as long as they don't go against the sharia. And adat is what? Ada is muhakkama. It determines on it.